Hey, sports fans, you've got a new men's and women's soccer team to cheer for at Marymount College. Don't go away. Hello, and thanks for joining us. I am Maria Sorreo, joined today by Greg Narleski, who is the athletic director at Marymount College, also head of student life. Thanks for being with us.
Thanks for having me.
Of course, of course. Now, we have a lot of exciting things to talk about with Marymount, but first of all, let's talk about a little bit about you. You're from the East Coast. How did you get to the West Coast?
Well, it's 12 years I've been working in higher education, and I was looking for a new position and something exciting, something different, and really opened up my job search to the whole country.
And you've had a lot to do with athletics. I know that in the Boston area you worked with fitness, and then you did some work in Philadelphia with the Eagles.
Sure.
So you've kind of been involved in sports kind of for a long time now.
Yeah, yeah. I was a sports management major at the University of Virginia, and that's where I got my degree, my bachelor's degree.
Okay.
So I've been working in the health club industry, personal training, and obviously always exciting to be able to work with a professional organization like the Philadelphia Eagles.
Now, I know you were a fan as well, so that was fun for you to work with the Eagles. What kind of things did you do with them?
Well, I started, it was an internship in the summer. I got to help set up their summer training camp at Westchester University back Rich Kotite's first year.
Wow.
So that was really exciting, get to be around the team and helping set up the camp. Also got to work with the special teams unit, so I was tracking statistics and actually in the huddle and things like that on the field. So that was really exciting.
Now, you also play Australian football, which is interesting to me. What is Australian football for people that don't know?
Well, there's five codes of football. There's obviously American football, soccer, rugby. There's Gaelic football, which is Ireland, and then Australian football.
Okay.
It's played on a cricket ground, so it's a large field, 18 a side. It's very physical and lots of kicking the football.
So how did a Boston, New Jersey guy end up playing Australian football?
Well, growing up in the 80s, ESPN used to have it on when ESPN first got started.
They
did. I first saw it then, and then when I went to BU to do my master's degree, professor there, advisor, was an expat Australian.
Okay.
And that's when the league got started in the U.S., and he got me hooked in then, and it's been a love since then,
okay,
for 10 years.
So for American football fans, how is it different from American football? What kind of things are different about it?
Well,
the field is bigger, I know you said.
It's more like soccer. There's no offsides, and it's a big oval, as I said, and there's four goalposts at either end. You have to kick it through the middle for 6 points or kick it through the side goals. It's only 1 point. So you're very much one-on-one with somebody, and it's keep away like any of the great games in the U.S., but very physical and fast-paced and high-scoring. So I think if people get to see it, I think Americans especially would really like it.
Is it the same time, the four quarters, or how does the time work on it?
Yeah, there's four quarters, four 20-minute to 25-minute quarters.
Okay.
So it's lots of running and lots of tackling and...
And you're still actually doing this with the San Diego team, is that right?
Yeah, yeah, okay. The San Diego Lions. So I'm still playing, and as long as I'm still able to get out there and have a kick, I'll still keep doing it.
That's great. Okay, so you came to Marymount a year and a half ago. How did you kind of get into the Marymount?
Yeah, I was as I mentioned, I was looking for a job, and I had a job search throughout the country. As you know, Marymount's a two-year private school, and I've only worked in higher education at a community college in Massachusetts, and then another private two-year college, a Dean College, for a few years. So I really like working with that type of student, a lot of students that maybe haven't found their way and are looking for extra opportunities.
Now, student life, exactly what does that mean? What do you do to kind of help the students out with that?
Yeah, we do... all the leadership programs on campus, student government, all the clubs and organizations. We bring in all the social comedians we might bring on campus, guest speakers, bands, any of those type of things, any of the social events going on campus. Really, anything that happens outside the classroom, that really falls to me.
So you're busy all the time.
Yes, yes, very busy.
And you're not too hurt about the Eagles losing last week, right?
Yeah, it's I'm very hurt. And obviously being in New England, too, it was a rough weekend for me.
Rough
the Patriots and the Eagles going down. So.
Yeah, let's talk about the exciting sports programs coming to Marymount.
Yeah.
You're starting a soccer team from the ground up. What has that been like?
Well, it's
a huge undertaking.
It is.
Yeah.
There's been lots of research, and we just decided last November to get going, or a year ago November.
Okay.
So we had to go out and find a coach, which we did a great job. met a lot of interesting people and lots of different ideas of how to get this program up and start up and started. And we were lucky to score Ben Graham as our soccer coach.
Yeah.
And he's done a miraculous job bringing in some student athletes and getting this first year under our belt. It's been a big challenge.
What was the response from the students?
Well, I think the students, faculty, and staff have all been really excited to have athletics back on campus because it's probably the one piece that we were missing at Marymount to really round out the whole college experience for our students.
And I know that you also have a lacrosse team,
mm-hmm.
and they actually work with the Boys and Girls Club in San Pedro.
They do.
And talk about that.
Yeah, it was our coach, Mike Folletta, did a great job trying to find. He also does our recreation events on campus.
Okay.
So he made a connection down at the Boys and Girls Club. Found out that they have some facilities because we don't have all the facilities that we necessarily need for our athletics. And if we volunteer down there, it's a mutual, everybody benefits.
That's right.
So our men's and women's lacrosse team volunteers, works with the students down at the Boys and Girls Club, and then we get to use their facilities to play lacrosse and have some indoor facilities, which is nice.
That's great. Now, how did they come up with a soccer program? I mean, why did they decide soccer?
Well, I think we're looking at numbers. We're looking at, obviously, budgetarily, what's going to be the best fit for us.
Okay.
And knowing that Southern California is so strong in soccer.
Sure.
And be able to bring in 50 student athletes for the men's and women's team really is going to fit our needs as a college. So that's why we went back and started with soccer.
Now, when will that start? Soon.
We actually started this past fall.
Okay.
We didn't have any wins this year, but really,
First year.
As our coach said, it's not really about the wins. These students will be remembered because they were the first year to bring it back on campus. So it was a really great experience for our students. Now, moving forward, Ben, our coach, is actually going to have a whole year to be able to recruit all the students that he needs, the student athletes he needs. So we're really looking forward to a big year next year.
And how many grades does that cover? As far as the players, like what age to what age can play soccer there?
Oh, sure. It's college age, so
any
student athlete. Some people might be older, some might be younger, but usually college age, 18 to 22.
And then who do you play? Which other teams? What other schools do you guys play?
This past year, we played a bunch of local club teams,
and
then we also played some of the community college teams. Moving forward, we're putting in an application with the NAIA to join that, and we'll be an independent team hopefully next year. This spring, we're working out all the paperwork with the NAIA, and then next year we'll be playing some NAIA teams, such as SoCA University down in Laguna Niguel, and
some other teams.
Yes.
Yes, lots of other teams.
Yes.
What was the biggest hurdle that you guys had to overcome starting a new program?
Well, really not having anything in place.
Yeah.
So it was a lot of calling other athletic directors, working with the NAIA to find out what are the protocols we need to have in place, coming up with a student athlete handbook, working with our academic folks to find out what special things we need to do for our student athletes, obviously study halls, those type of things.
Right.
Coming up with our recruiting, scholarships, all those things that go into a strong athletics program.
It must have been so exciting for you for the first game to be out there with that.
Yeah.
See it all come together.
Yeah, it's been really great. And probably our best part was we really don't have a full-size field, but during our homecoming weekend, our family weekend, we were able to have our women's team play the club team.
Oh, wow.
We had to play 9-a-side instead of 11-a-side, but
okay.
It was great to have our first home game, and the ladies did really well. They didn't win the game, but they did really well.
That's very cool, very cool. So now you're an Australian football player. Any soccer or lacrosse?
Yeah,
I pretty much
have done a little bit of everything. Growing up, I played soccer in New Jersey, and in college at the University of Virginia, my fraternity, I got to play in the intramurals. I was the goalie for our lacrosse team. They threw me in there. They needed somebody, so that was a lot of fun.
You know, it's interesting because you have such a heavy sports background. That must help you a lot with the school, I would think.
Yeah, I think when I came here, I didn't know I was going to be the athletic director when I got here. I just came in as the director of student life. And, lucky for me, you got to be careful what you ask for.
Yeah.
Because when you have a lot of skills like that, I'm glad they asked me to do it because I think it's a new challenge for me and something different. So it's exciting.
Very cool. Well, we're going to be out at Marymount and, of course, talking to the lacrosse team and the soccer team this year. And, Greg, thank you so much for being with us today. Even though he's an Eagles fan, it's all right. And we'll be coming out to Marymount College, of course, to interview the boys and girls, men and women's team for lacrosse and for soccer. And don't you go away. We'll be right back.